I really just get into that vibe. So let me know what you thought that you. disregard last comment. Do this and get better at making techno grooves. That is today's video. Let's go do it right now. Hey, what's up? I'm Minilogue Kitchen and thank you for checking out yet another video. Now, if this is your first time here, don't hesitate to click subscribe. You'll be notified whenever I upload a new video, but that is when you click that bell icon as well. You'll be kept in the loop. You won't miss out on anything. Thanks to everyone who's supporting me on my Patreon page, and you can find it on patreon.com/analogkitchen. I've got Patreon connected to Discord, and there's a whole lot of like-minded synthesizer enthusiasts. So I need to say what's up, Lorenzo Del Col, Traversi, Tough Chunks, Spazoo, Mats Boberg, Haslo, Carson, Slim Pickens, hey to Bart, Avlantis, Wijnand Funk. There's so many cool cats over on my the Patreon page. It's really cool. Last week we were in the voice chat talking about all different stuff, and it's really cool to find like-minded people. So where I thought I was the only synth nerd out there that's really getting into this specific niche of the market, mind you, there's strength in numbers. Now, techno comes from America. That's where it originated, and that was like ages ago. And the people that get credit for it the most are the Belleville Three, which are Juan Atkins, Derek May, and you guessed it.
Please hurry up.
Kevin Saunderson. Ooh, I heard crickets there. That sound has evolved. When you're looking at techno now, if you look at Beatport or for instance, any other platform where you buy your music from, you'll see that there are so many different kinds of techno artists. So would you consider Carl Cox to be a techno artist? Yes. Would you consider Art Bar to be a techno artist? Yes. Tale of Us to be a techno artist? Yes. Would you consider Adam Baird to be a techno artist? And then Sasha, would you consider him to be a techno artist?
Oh, yes, of course.
Yes. Nowadays, it all gets classified under that techno umbrella. But the nuances literally go from left to right across the board. Now, that doesn't really matter to you if you're on a dance floor, but it does matter if you want to produce certain styles and you don't know what kind of sound you really want to dig into. There is, however, a way of picking sounds that will always work no matter what kind of sound you make. Now, I try to do it that way. My tracks, the way I produce them, it's a modular approach. Let me put it that way, because a song can be approached from different angles. If, say, I was playing a daytime event and it's hot weather and it's a beach setting, something less underground, more vibey, then probably I would start out with having lush sounds. But I won't change my drums around. I'll just mix them differently. So the kick will be slightly softer, but the balance would be completely different if I would do that in the nighttime. Then I would not play as much lush sounds. I will just like have shorter attacks, have a little bit more resonance on the sounds that I'm using, but the drums then are predominantly further in your face. So a trick to use is later in the night, louder the drums. That's how I literally do it. And that helps if you've got like good sounds that you have selected from the get-go. So I hear a lot of kick drums that I think like, that's not gonna win you the battle. I am sorry, but you need to just like make sure that the sounds you're using are actually sounds that you can rely on to be great on whatever system you get to. And it doesn't matter whether you're just like gonna play for your local beer place or you just wanna be like up on that stage for thousands of people, the sound needs to be the sound. Within that 20 hertz and 20K, you need to span out throughout the whole spectrum. Now, I will take you over to the live set and show you on how I just do that. Maybe also tell you how you can get more out of the one drum set or drum sound that you use. Another question a lot of people ask me is, do you use different drum kits all the time? And I'm like, no. I know there's ample amount of memory nowadays on any machine you do, and when you work with a DAW, and obviously you can just like stuff up that hard drive all you want. But back in the days, we just had the one drum computer. It was a 909, 808, or whatever, Lindrum, and we made do. And when you look at Acid House, it was the TB-303 and a 909, and there were 48-hour parties. Nobody came in like, oh, okay, after the second record, hey, maybe you should change the drums around because I don't like it. No. So I literally have got that same philosophy on my sound. I will probably not change my kick drum, change my clap out too much. What I will do though is add more drums to it so that with a different track, it feels like you're listening to a different drum set, but not everything has changed, you know? So maybe the toms will get swapped out for a top loop that plays, or maybe there are congas that you didn't hear in the first record, and that's how I can add some variety to my drums. But the kick drum, that's my foundation, gonna kick you in the butt. First record and the last record that I did, you need to feel that the kitchen passed your door, you know what I mean? And that's exactly the way I approached my techno drums. Now to get techno grooves, you have to do this to get better at them. You need to just focus on what is it that I wanna do? How does my sound needs to sound? Having a mental print or a picture on how you wanna do that wins a lot of, you know, it eliminates a lot of this, like running around in circles and not getting to the result that you want. You know, we wanna get to the result and we wanna get there fast. So I will show you a few things to take into consideration. So follow along those steps and you should get better at making techno grooves. Now, for a techno sound, let's start with a kick. Or shall I tell you what's in the box? I'll tell you briefly what's in the box. I've got hidden away underneath the Korg Minilogue XD. I've got an audio thing is Micromonster. Then there's the multi-clock, which is right here, serving up MIDI to the Akai MPC Live. That's joined at the hip with the Octatrack, so those two are linked up together. If I switch a pattern here, this one will instantly change, and I've mapped it up in a way that the bottom eight squares make up one song and the top eight squares make up another song. So there's eight different banks that I can use, up to age, and that means that per bank I have two songs, so that's 16 songs in total. And then there are 16 tracks or 16 banks on the Octatrack as well, so I've mapped it so that when I switch a bank here, this will also go into a bank, and then you can use multiple patterns. But because there's only four MIDI parts in here, which means you can stick four different sounds within the same bank on the same trig, as they would call it. Obviously, I would have liked to see 16 trigs so that I could be a little bit more flexible. But then again, it makes you think, okay, so I can switch four times within a bank in terms of different sounds. So it's cool to just mute stuff on the Octatrack if I want to make a breakdown. So it means that I can do more with two hands. Anyway, that's a bit of a tech talk. Tetra's right here. The Acid Box 3 is over here. That I got wired up to a different output. So the stereo output of the Octatrack goes onto my little mixer over here. And then there's inputs on the Octatrack for the Moog, the Model D, and for the Tetra, the TB-03, which is over here, which plays acid. Well, if I hit it. Ooh. Remind me to change the cable. All right, so that's over there. And then, yeah, what else? Well, I've got the Launch Control XL wired up to the Akai MPC Live. Okay, now I've got a techno sound that I'm gonna use here. I'm going to go for a little bit more of that dubby kind of techno vibe that I really like. So you need a few things. First of all, obviously you need a kick. That kick works, yeah? Now, what I also, and what I'm also going to do is add some more drums. Like, let's start with a basic sort of like four to the floor groove and see what we can do to get this techno groove going. Now this is simple, this is easy for you to program. Now get a sound that is deep and rich in nature and play something crazy with that. How are we going to do that? We're going to go over to the Model D instantly, and I'm going to just make a sound on here and detune the three oscillators so you get that rich kind of techno tone instantly. Let's see if we can make that work. So I'm gonna go over to here, go over to the track that says Model D. I've got my tracks laid out already, so the sounds are there. You can hear it. Sure that I got the same key, so I'm gonna need to go over here. That's the sound, yeah? So I got it here, turn it up. Turn it off some more. I'm not going to go too complicated. Simple, yeah? Ding dong, bam, 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 bang, bam, bam. Okay, turn it off. Now I'm going to shorten the note. As you can hear, there's a bit of reverb on there because it goes through the octave track, as I told you. So I will go over here, go over there, and just turn that off a little bit. What I'm gonna do is turn it up like so. So I'm going to stick the reverb on the scene B, open it up. So if I'm gonna open up the crossfader, you will hear the reverb increase dramatically, which is a cool trick that we're going to use later on. All right, turn off the reverb, go back again. Now I'm going to put the level of this sound just on top of the bass drum. If I turn it up completely, it's going to start eating off the frequency of the kick. And since I don't sidechain or compress everything, leveling is very important. So, okay, I've got this one, yeah? Now, the second oscillator, which I'm going to steer on a triangle wave with the ramp up. Let's turn it on. You can instantly hear that it's getting a little bit more gritty. Now, I'm going to turn this one up. Let's lengthen the notes a little bit so you can hear what I'm doing. This one is on 8 in terms of the pitch, which goes from low 32, 16, 8, 4, and 2. And then the third oscillator, which is also going to be on a square wave, I'm going to also turn. Now I've got a basic minor chord, yeah? Ba, ba, ba. Yeah, nice. Now I'm going to stick some noise on there. Yeah, go back. We like it. Come on. There's an overload button on the Model D, so we can even make it a little bit more gritty. Turn down the noise because it's a bit too crunchy. And now let's add a little bit of reverb and add more drums. Okay, you can dance to this, right? A little bit less on the reverb. And what I'm gonna do is see if I can add some more drums to it, because I need a little bit more of, I think, a clap. That clap is just gonna play on the same place as the kick is playing. See? So we're gonna go in, assign samples, we're gonna go in here. Select the plan, look for a clap, browse. Exactly, that's what we want. There you go. Oh, that's nice. Now what I'm going to do is turn warp off, because that's exactly what's going to happen. Warp, there you go. All right, so play that again. So what we got now is this. Right, clap is here. Let's record it straight in. 2, 3, and. Nice. Now let's turn that down a little bit, because I think it's a bit on the loud side. Okay, I think I went a little bit too enthusiastic on my clap, so what I'm gonna do is go in. Oh, you know what? I can just go easy and do it like this. maybe pitch it down a little bit as well, because I think this might be a little bit too... Zoom in, see how everything is. I switch the attack a little bit later into the clap so that the clap sits a little bit better on top of the kick. Okay, nice. Nice. Now, let's add the Minilogue XD, which, if I'm not mistaken, is on 4B. That's what I want. Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice. Thing is, I think we can go a little bit crazier on there. Is there a sound on the octatrack that we can use? I think there is. Let's see, what's this here? Yep, piano. Now, I'm going to go into the sample first because I want to edit it, which means I'm going over here and then, let's see. Yeah, nice. Get out of there. So now in the program, now I'm gonna go to chromatic mode over here so that I can play it. If obviously where you're going out of group, turn it on. Select the piano, like so. Nice one. I'm digging this. Cool. Now get out of there. Get over to the filter. Still a little bit on the soft side, so let's go into this sample, double click, enter, turn it up a little bit more. Check this out. See where we're going. Take out the kick. Build up some dramatic stuff here. You gotta love it, man. And the thing is, it needs to be hypnotizing, you know, it needs to just go down, down. Right, let's start the multi-clock. All right, so now, so far I'm thinking, not too bad. What is it? Now the thing to start your techno track, because we just added a lot of stuff, is I'm going to turn everything off that is not supposed to play. So the first two tracks on my Octatrack, I'm going to lower everything. So this is pretty much how I think that I'm going to just build it up. This one I've already programmed, which is a polymeter. I'll go for the triangle waveform here as well. Make it a little less aggressive. Okay. Start my kick drum. Instantly we're like, okay, we're going, you know? No if, buts, maybes, just into the zone. Lower all the filters because this thing needs to just like grow on you quite easily. Nice one. Kick out, hi-hat, 2-3. Now that I'm listening to it, I think that clap might be a little bit on the loud side, so I will make sure that I'm going to turn that down a little bit more. I'll go in, lower it slightly. Nice one. Filter here as well, so we'll go on to the second track. Now this you can map as well, but then there's a few tricks that you need to do with your MIDIs in order for a Launch Control XL to just work on this as well. But since I've got my MIDI in already occupied by the Akai MPC Live, I need to split it. So for sake of argument today, let's not do that. Let's go a little bit further. Now it's time for me to add the Model D. Instantly, let's add a little bit more reverb. Easy going. Did you notice that I'm not tweaking that TB-03 to go like completely acid housey? Just stays in that same spot. You can open it up a little bit like so. Take a little bit of the edge off of the Model D. And then slowly take out the kick. Work your way up to the next sound. Shorten the release. Open the vibe and just get in there here. Put some reverb on there as well. Ah! So in short, it's basically, you know, getting a few things to just go to play in time with each other. So my drums are not too complicated, but if you work this into a club and it works well, you can definitely feel that, wow, there's a lot of power coming out of the beats, coming out of your groove. And yeah, you know, I mean, in the end of the day, it's not too complicated to really make some really cool techno music. This is a bit dubby if I turn this off, you know, and I'll just keep it something like what I was playing. This, easy, turn it on. Obviously you can get your kick even to go louder, put a little bit of reverb on there if you want. But I want them Robert Hood kind of techno vibe that I really like, you know, because you can really go different directions with it. If I play chords on the Minilogue, then it becomes a little bit more melodic techno. But for now, I would just love to just like stay in that same groove. Mute my clap. Enter the clap. Of course, if you like the music and you want to support me there, that's possible because you can head over to Bandcamp, and that's where I, if the jams turn out well, because I do jams, sometimes I like them, most often I don't, but if I do like them, I'll just chop them up into eatable bite-sized segments, which you can purchase for next to nothing on my Bandcamp page. So go over there, support me there, follow it there. It's a lot of following though. Thank you for your support, and yeah, that's that. Let me know what you thought you took away from this video, and if there's anything I should know, just leave me a comment, you know, don't be a stranger. Thanks for viewing anyway. Links to all the equipment, note info below. If you haven't subscribed yet, do so. You'll be more than welcome. If you really dig the vibe and I taught you something you didn't know was possible, or you thought it was possible, but not in this sense, or you just got inspired, head over to Patreon and support me on patreon.com/analogkitchen, where I'm actually doing a few things. I'm making better content, so that's where your hard-earned money is going. You can start at about $1, so you won't be breaking the bank. We're also building a mixer. And that's absolutely amazing, because I do think there's a gap in between the club and the studio mixer. And the gain stage is done, that works. The filter section is being tested as we speak, and that looks promising. So this mixer is going to happen, man. It's really going to be cool. Yeah, go and check it out. Now, Patreon's also connected to Discord, so you can actually have a chat with me, have a chat with all the like-minded folks that are in there. We're building a small, yet very strong, very positive, very respectful community. And yeah, you're more than welcome to join. So if you're enlist on the slightly higher tiers on my Patreon page, which is still not breaking the bank, you will get access to a lot of information and also challenges. This month's challenge is how to make a Dawless track from scratch, 5 minutes, and then just get in there. So a lot of people are diving on that that thing, and it's really cool. All right, so if not anything else, I would like to say thanks all you new subscribers. Subscribe if you did not do so already. I think I said that already. I think I'm running around the circles. Anyway, so if not anything else, then I will see you on the other side of the screen next week on another video. Peace.